We thank you, Lord, that you're a good God, full of life, full of hope, and you give us a future. And all God's people said,
amen.
I love this song as it talks about God is good. And I have their children talking the other week saying, oh, they're good. And I say, there's only one that's good, and that is God. Because we try to measure up what good is, but we don't really know what good is. Only God does. Is that right?
Thank you.
free by the power of the blood of the Lamb. We're being set free by you. You know, I feel today is an invitation to come into His presence.
To be my voice to the Lord.
was not for evil, and it's to offer a hope and a future. And I feel in this time, there's like a sense of urgency. There's a clarion call going out. Come bright, rise in this time. Come rise and prepare your hands for battle. Because He is the Lord God, the host of the army. He is the King of the Lord's army. Amen. You know, I just want to allow time for the breath of God. Because I really sense the Lord is just starting to show us pictures. If you just close your eyes and come into that place, He will show you things. And even in this season, I know people are starting to see visions and dream things and start to sense something in their innermost being. There's a restlessness in this earth and in the nations. And I believe, you know, God is trying to raise up an army. And Ezekiel says, can these dry bones live? And yes, they can. It doesn't matter your age. It doesn't matter who you are or where you've been. God can use you. And He's called you by name for such a time as this. He's called you to come into alignment with what He's doing in this time. And it's not time to tarry, and it's not time to be busy out. As in the days in Noah, they were drinking and getting drunk and doing whatever they please. It's a time to be motivated and aligning yourself with what God has called you to do in this time. And I believe that we need a spirit of boldness in this time to come upon us and to just challenge us, because there are so many lost and broken. There are so many that need what we have, which is the living God. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Brenda was singing Come Into His Presence. And I just want to read Genesis 45. And verse 10 and 11. It says, "You shall dwell in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near to me, you and your children and your children's children, your flocks and your herds and all that you have. For there I will provide for you, lest you and your household and all that you have come to poverty, for there is still 5 years of famine." You know, and Joseph was saying that, but I'm saying, this is God saying this to us. And you know what the word Goshen means? It means drawing, or drawing near. You know, what God is saying is that, you know, here were the children of Israel that were in the promised land, but they actually had experienced famine for 2 years, the famine that was prophesied through Joseph. And you know, they had to experience that famine, otherwise they never would have moved. So 2 years of famine, and then God delivered them out of the next 5 years of famine. But here was the interesting thing. And then they had to come from the promised land into the world to actually get the protection of God and the provision of God. But not only Joseph said, "God has sent me here so that you would survive." Not only did they survive, they prospered. Amen. They prospered so much that when the next Pharaoh came along, he saw them as a threat. And I believe that in the midst of everything that's going on at the moment, and in the midst of the world systems and everything that's going on, God is saying, draw near to me. Because as you draw near to me, not only will you survive what's going on, but you'll prosper through that. Amen? Because I know I've been preaching so much about what happened to the children of Israel is happening right now. You know, they had to go into lockdown while the angel of death went over, and then God took them into the wilderness, but he protected and he provided for them. Amen? And even right back here, when he drew them out of Canaan, he said, "I'm going to bring you into the world, but I'm going to draw you near to me, and I will not only help you survive, but I will actually help you prosper." Amen? So I just believe that's what God's saying at the moment, is that if we look to him, we don't need to fear what's going on around us. If we look to him, not only will we get through this, but we will prosper through this. Amen? Because God is our provider. God is our protector. And all he wants to do is just keep drawing close to him. When you see what's going around, just draw close to him. Amen? Hallelujah. Stuart, would you come and take us around the computer? Thank you.
Good morning, church. I'm going to do mainly reading today instead of ad lib. The Lord's Supper is celebrated in Matthew 20, 17 to 30, Mark 14, 17 to 25, Luke 22, 14 to 20, 1 Corinthians 11, 23-28. This morning I'm going to read from Matthew 26, 17 to 30. Jesus celebrates the Passover feast. And I better put my glasses on, I can't read anything else now. Verse 17. Now on the first day of the feast of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus saying to him, "Where do you want us to prepare for you to eat the Passover?" And he said, "Go into the city to a certain man and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is at hand. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples.' So the disciples did as Jesus directed them, and they had prepared the Passover. When evening had come, he sat down with the 12. Now as they were eating, he said, 'Assuredly I say unto you, one of you will betray me.' And they were exceedingly sorrowful. And each of them began to say to him, 'Lord, is it I?' He answered and said, 'He who dips his hand with me in the dish will betray me. The Son of Man indeed goes, just as it is written of him. But woe to that man to whom the Son of Man is betrayed. Then Judas, who was betraying him, answered and said, Rabbi, is it I? And he said, You have said it. And as they were eating, Jesus took the bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to the disciples and said, Take, eat, this is my body. Then he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, Drink from it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the remissions of sins. But I say to you, I will not drink of the vine, but the fruit of the vine, from now until the day when I drink it with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Now I'm going to take a few comments on this, and the comments come over that the Passover feast was one of those amazing prophetic pictures of Christ as fulfilled. The Apostle Paul calls the Old Testament events shadows of things to come, and explains that the reality, the substance, the fact of what is foreshadowed, that's in Colossians 2:17. Just as the Passover was the first feast of the people of Israel, we were commanded to observe, so is Christ's death on the cross, the first truth we must believe if we are to be free from the slavery of sin, saved from judgment of the world, and recipients of eternal life. It is not enough just to know and understand that Christ has fulfilled all these things. We must believe in our hearts that Christ is truly our Passover lamb. We have come out of the world through the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross. A good example of this is when Israel came out of Egypt. The Passover lamb with the blood on the lintels and on the doorpost, and then the sacrifice eaten with nothing left behind. Jesus and his blood outpoured in death, recalling the sacrificial rites of the Old Testament is represented in the cup of blessing on the table. The cup is invested with a fresh significance as the memorial of the new exodus of the new covenant for all believers. All of us who believe have started on a new journey, a new exodus out of this world into the new kingdom of God. We'll take the bread and I'll say the prayer and we'll eat it together. Father in heaven, we believe that Jesus is our Passover lamb, and eat this bread in memory of his sacrifice on the cross, in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, as Jesus said he would drink of the fruit of the vine in your kingdom, we drink it with him in his memory, in the name of Jesus. And Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me.